R2, are you in the workbench area?
Huh, no.
Oh, hey everyone, and welcome to Groove Builders, the show where we create together. I'm your host, Disorderly Cone, and in this episode, we're going to be building the last model in the Red Dead Redemption 2 Metal Earth series, the train. And with it being a whopping 3 sheets, it might be the most detailed model we've built yet. Now, R2 and I had just finished building the Maxim gun mount that we're going to put on the train a little bit later, and he kind of disappeared on me. I guess we're going to have to try to build this train without him. I'm a little bit worried too, but I think we can do it together, Groove Builders. Let's get down to the workbench and take a look at the package.
Groove Builders, welcome to the workbench. We have our Metal Earth Red Dead Redemption 2 train in some pretty awesome Rockstar packaging. Let's go ahead and take a look at the back. On the back, we have that Metal Earth logo, followed by a look at some other models in the series. Now, we've built the sawed-off shotgun, we've built the Maxim gun, and now we're on to the train. And if it's anything like the other models in the series, you can bet it's going to be big and full of detail. Now, just below that, we get a look at how to build this model, but we're going to go into more detail about that during the build. Now, at the very bottom, we get a difficulty indicator, and while these aren't necessarily always accurate, in the past two models, it's been pretty good. Groovers, let's go ahead and open up our package. We have our instructions, and we have our 3 sheets of metal. Wow, look at all of these parts, Groovers. This is going to be a very big build. Groovers, let's get building. Grabbing our metal and our wire cutters, we begin to cut out our first couple of pieces for our Red Dead Redemption 2 train. And already handling these pieces, I can tell there's going to be a lot of interesting forming with this model. So we're going to have to pay extra close attention to all these little fold lines and all these little tabs so we don't accidentally misshape anything. I know that for myself, when it comes to building some of these bigger Metal Earth models, I find myself kind of rushing through some of the detail, especially if it's repeated. And I got to be very, very careful not to do that with this train here, because I really want this to turn out as good as the last two models have turned out, even with all of their incredibly unique detail. One pro tip that I'm going to get in right away before we even get into the instructions for building this model is that you're going to need to have a good pair of pliers and a good pair of tweezers to be able to form all of your parts. Just because a lot of the parts with this particular build are very skinny, if you're trying to bend it just by yourself while holding it in your hand, you're going to actually warp the piece very easily. So you're going to need to actually hold it with a pair of pliers right up against the fold line and then use your tweezers to bend the part. Once it's already bent, it's pretty easy to get into shape, but that initial bend can be very difficult, and if not done right, you will warp that piece, making it almost impossible to get that nice crisp finish that you want. But with that pro tip out of the way, let's go ahead and look at our instructions. R2? R2? Oh, right, I forgot. I still can't find him anywhere. Okay, let me just try some buttons here. This one. Oh, nope, that's not the right button at all. Sorry about this, guys. Let me try this button here. R2 is really good to have around here because he's good at this kind of stuff. I kind of just fumble my way through. Let's try this one. Ah, there we go. Excellent. The instructions. Starting at the top, we have that Metal Earth logo, followed by a good look at our train. Then just below, we have a QR code, which we can scan to get a 360 view of our train while we're building. This is very useful for seeing how different parts of detail are attached to our train. You don't want to install any of those parts upside down, Groovers. Next, just below, we get a look at our 3 sheets of metal. Now, I always recommend taking our metal sheets and orientating them to these 3 pictures. And the reason for that is it makes it a lot easier for us to be able to find our parts when we need them. Now, Groovers, when we're looking at our instructions, you'll see numbers. These numbers correspond with different parts on our metal sheet. Now you'll also see these different colors here. Those colors represent duplicate parts, and that is very useful for finding multiple pieces, say for the train wheels, a little bit later on. Okay, now I just gotta turn the page over. Let me try this button. Now this button. Ah, there we go, excellent. Now we get a look at one of our parts. Here you'll see labeled our insertion tabs, our insertion holes, and our fold lines. it's very important that we bend all of our parts along the fold lines, making sure that all of our tabs go into the insertion holes. Sometimes we can actually bend our tabs either one way or another to help us go into those holes a little bit easier. Once they're in, you're going to need to either fold them or twist them over according to the instructions. This little picture pretty much describes the basics of metal model building, so it's very important that we have a good grasp of this before moving on any further. Next, we have
the Almighty Legend.
And the first two things we see are the engraved and non-engraved symbols. These are scattered everywhere in our instructions, and they're very important to pay attention to because they're going to tell us what side of the part needs to be facing outward or inward depending on the detail. Groovers, nothing is worse than putting a part onto your model and building all the way up to a certain point only to realize that something is wrong, and then of course looking at the model and realizing that the piece that you installed on backwards is like six steps back, which means you have to take apart the entire thing just to get to that one piece. So anytime you see these engraved symbols, always make sure you pay extra close attention. Which brings us on to our next symbol, the attention point, which normally we never see, but in these instructions, they're everywhere, and they're used in a variety of ways. For instance, they're all around the wheel wells of the train, making sure that you take extra close attention to how the pieces are formed and making sure the detail is on the proper side. Some other times that we encounter the attention point is we're inserting different pieces onto the train that have a lot of insertion holes right next door to each other. It's very important that we make sure that we insert our pieces into their proper holes. Otherwise, we might find ourselves having a bad time. Next, we have our circles and our triangles. Groovers, these are scattered through all of our instructions, and for good reason, because they tell us what to do with our tabs. Now, groovers, I always recommend following the instructions first, and then after building, going over your model again. If you see any tabs that you think may look a little bit better a different way, doing it then. But what do you do when you see a circle? Well, every single time you see a circle, you want to take as much of the tab in your tweezers as possible and then bend it down 90 degrees. When you see the triangles, you want to take as much of the tab in your tweezers as possible and twist it 90 degrees. Both of these are great ways for securing your pieces. But again, groovers, always make sure to follow the instructions first. Then afterwards, experimenting with different bends to see what looks a little bit better. And finally, moving on to our right, we have our recommended tool section. And the first tool we see is one that I highly recommend, and that is our wire cutters. Wire cutters are extremely important for cutting out all of our pieces to build our model. I definitely don't recommend taking your pieces and trying to bend them out of the sheets of metal. This is a very bad idea because it's going to warp all of your pieces, and that nice finish you want is not going to be achieved. Having a good pair of wire cutters will make sure that all the little bits of metal are cut off, making sure that your piece stays in great condition. The next tools they recommend are tweezers and needle nose pliers, both of which we kind of touched on at the beginning of the video. Groovers, I really recommend having a good set of tweezers when building any of these metal models. If you can bend your tweezers in your hand by yourself, those aren't really great for building with just because they're too flexible. And I find sometimes the tweezers that come with some of these kits just really don't live up to the expectation and the quality that you're expecting. So a good set of tweezers will go a long way. When it comes to needle nose pliers, I'm way less picky than I am with my tweezers, finding that pretty much any pair will do. However, I find the smaller ones are always better to use when it comes to forming some of the smaller bits of detail that we have to with this train. That's why you see me using my smaller set. Some other tools you'll see me using is my doming set, which is those white rods. Those are very useful for forming some of the bigger pieces when it comes to our train, but for the most part, a good handheld mandrel will do you just fine. And with that, Groove Builders, we're done with our instructions. Let me just press this button here. Ha! See? I'm getting the hang of this. Our little steam locomotive here is really coming along, and I have to admit, it looks really good in comparison to the in-game model of the Red Dead Redemption 2 train. I mean, just look. It's pretty awesome, right? I think they did a great job of capturing this model. And one other thing I kind of started wondering is, where did the first steam locomotive come from? For that answer, we have to go across the pond to the United Kingdom. The first working steam locomotive was a massive beast of a machine. It was called the Colebrook Dale Locomotive, built by Trevithick in 1802. On the 21st of February, 1804, the first recorded steam-hauled railway journey took place, but it was far from the train that we are building here. A lot more innovation would need to take place, and believe it or not, people riding on the railroad was an afterthought that came a lot longer down the road. In 1829, the famous Rocket was entered into a contest with four other locomotives, running along a 1.6 kilometer level track. The Rocket was the only locomotive that completed the trials. It averaged about 19 kilometers an hour as it went down the track, and achieved a top speed of 48 kilometers an hour, hauling 13 tons, winning them the $500 prize, and a contract for production. As time went on, engineers found more ways to improve the speed and effectiveness of steam locomotives, and by 1899, where Red Dead Redemption 2 is taking place, trains became the main way to get around the country, where horseback was just too long. And a good thing too. How else are we gonna get rich in the Old West without robbing trains on bridges, right? We just have to remember to pack a few extra pieces of dynamite and stop the train before the end of the bridge. That way the lawman can't get us. If I can find R2, I'll make sure he sees to that. Only if he would answer his cell phone.
Everyone, and welcome back. We did it. We built the train from Red Dead Redemption 2. And I must admit, out of all the models in this series, this one is definitely the most detailed and the most difficult to build. But not very much more than that Maxim gun we built last time. Let's talk about what it took to build this train in construction. My first point when it comes to building the Red Dead Redemption 2 train is to make sure you have the proper tools on hand before building it. And what I mean by that is at least two pairs of tweezers or a good pair of tweezers and a set of pliers. And the reason why I recommend that is that there's a lot of small detail on this train, especially along here in the front. And the only way to properly bend those pieces is to use both tools at the same time, making sure you go right up to that folding line before you bend the piece. If you don't do this, you might find yourself warping a couple of these pieces and you won't get that nice finish that we try to get. My second point is about the cylinder here on the train. In the video, I waited to the last possible second to close it. And the reason for that is for all this detail that we install on it. Now, I really shouldn't have waited as long as I did because it made it really hard to form this into the cylinder that I wanted to. So my recommendation is to actually close this before putting the detail on it. I know it might be a little bit harder to get all the tabs, but you'll thank yourself in the end with the nice cylinder you have. My third and final point when it comes to building this train is that yes, there is a lot of detail, and you really don't want to accidentally scratch any of the metal on the outside. How do you go about attaching all of this detail without scratching it? Well, the best way to do this is to actually pre-bend one of your tabs on your pieces. You'll find that oftentimes it will slide right into place, allowing you to secure the tabs underneath. This is especially useful when it comes to putting pieces here on the cylinder and along the wheels, so make sure that you pre-bend the tab just a little bit before putting them together. You'll thank me in the end. And with that being said, Groove Builders, let's move on to build time. The Metal Earth Red Dead Redemption 2 train took me just over 4.5 hours to build, with the majority of that time being spent building this engine up here. All of the wheels and this detail definitely took its time, but Groove Builders, remember, it's never a race to get these things completed, because the amount of time you spend on these is definitely reflected in the end. And finally, Groove Builders, my thoughts. Of the three models in the Red Dead Redemption 2 series from Metal Earth, the train is definitely the most detailed, which means you're going to spend a lot of time on this one making sure everything looks just right. And the team over at Metal Earth did a really good job of capturing the in-game model. I mean, it really does look really good in comparison to that train. Now, there are some things that I don't really like, and that is mainly that this right here is connected by tabs, but we've seen in some other models where the back caboose is actually attached by a pin. Now, this might be done for accuracy reasons, and I completely understand that, but it just kind of leaves it a little bit flimsy, and if you're ever holding in your hand, you'll feel like it's going to break. Now, some other things I want to say about this train is that of all the trains that we've built here on the show, this one is the least detailed. Now, that being said, outside of the show, I have built some other trains. And in comparison, I mean, yes, it does look pretty good. So for instance, this here is the Disney train. This is the one that Disney built for his wife. And it's actually really, really nicely detailed. And I actually have another one that we're gonna build here on the show at a later date. But you'll notice this one here has a lot more detail that I think they did a lot better job on. When you look at this train, I mean, yes, it does look really good, but I think they could have done a little bit better. I mean, even against the Hogwarts here Express, I mean, that one is really, really detailed. And that one has that caboose with a pin on the back that I was talking about. Very, very cool. But again, this train should not be put down. There's a lot of really cool things about it. And if you're a Red Dead Redemption 2 fan, you're definitely gonna wanna put this into your collection. And with that being said, Groove Builders, we're at the end of our show. I had a really good time building the Metal Earth Red Dead Redemption 2 train with you. And, oh, I'm sorry, just one moment. Oh, hey, R2, where are you? You are building targets for the train tracks? I should have looked there first. Guess what our friends and I just finished building? The train! Looks pretty cool, doesn't it? Okay, let me finish up with these guys and I'll be right there, okay, buddy? Okay. All right, guys, I had a really good time building this train with you, and if you guys had a good time, don't forget to press that like button. For more videos like this, hit subscribe as well, as we got all kinds of really cool content coming out in the future. Until next time, Groove Builders, keep building. Now, R2 and I got some targets to shoot. This should be fun.